Am I right? Anything you get excited about will do something to you. The Holy Ghost is the power of God. And you're not a fanatic when you praise God. Some of y'all are too weak because you won't praise God. You won't shout. You won't dance. You go to the club and you dance. They drunk. The Bible says the Holy Ghost is the same way to the body as drunkenness is to the body. He compared the Holy Ghost many times to alcoholic drunkard. Many times. Apostle Paul said, don't be like drunk with wine. Be filled with the Spirit. A person that's drunk, you can't tell them to stop talking. You can't tell them to sit down. You can't tell them to act like they got no sense because they ain't going to act. That Holy Ghost in them called liquor, that's their Holy Ghost. And that liquor moving. That liquor talking to them. That liquor making them move. And if you get filled with God's Spirit, you can't sit down like a lump on rock. This thing. The Holy Ghost can't be controlled. He controls us. I say he controls us. You see a man drunk driving, the police stop him. Say A, say A, B, C. He's like A, Z, B, L, O, U, B, T. They tell him to walk straight. He be walking. He can't do it. And the reason I can tell, he's full of it. He owns salvation process. How many of you been in a swimming pool? Oh, Lord. When you get in the pool, you have got water all over you. But none of it's in you. And you get out of the pool, or sometimes be still in the pool and want somebody to bring you some water. That's what I'm trying to tell all you good Christians that's been baptized in the Holy Ghost. You got it all over you, but you need to get some on the inside. It's one baptism, but many. That's why we put you on this consecration and fast to try to get you to know that man don't live by bread alone. And until you get to that point that you realize I can live without butter beans and black eyed peas. I can live without a steak and some chicken. Until you get to that point, you'll never get what God wants you. You got to give it up. You got to give up food. You got to give up your time. You got to give up your husband and wife sometimes. You got to give up the failures of marriage. Apostle Paul said, sometime when God pull you, you got to ask your wife, is it all right? Because I'm seeking God and I can't do what I'm supposed to do. But I want you to let me know now because God is pulling me away. Some of y'all too sex crazy. You'll never get the Holy Ghost thinking about sex in the morning, in the evening, in the noon, and in the night.